Hello guys, how are you today? Today we are going to work in the Smarty book, so please open your Smarty book on page number 38. Open your Smarty book on page number 38. What are we going to do here? Look, listen. Read and sing the poem, invent the melody, okay? First of all, we're going to read this poem and we are going to underline the rhymes, the rhymes. I'm going to say that in Spanish, okay? Vamos a leer este poema. Vamos a subrayar las palabras que hacen la rima. ¿Y qué va a suceder después? Tú vas a ponerle la melodía a un poema para que te des cuenta que un poema, una poesía, puede convertirse en una canción, okay? So, please listen to me and underline the rhymes, okay? With red color, please. The name of the poem is Clouds. White sheep on a blue hill. When the wind stops, you all stand still. Hill, still. Hill, still. Okay? When the wind blows, you walk away slow. White sheep, where do you go? Maybe when the wind blows, you walk away slow. Maybe, white sheep, where do you go? Slow, go, slow, go. Okay, maybe, those, okay? I'm gonna read again the poem for you. Please, listen to me and the pronunciation, please. White sheep on a blue hill. When the wind stops, you all stand still. When the wind blows, you walk away slow. White sheep, where do you go? Okay, it's your turn to invent the melody, okay? And to sing this song, okay? The next part, draw a picture of your poem. Draw a picture of the poem, okay? You're going to make a picture of this. White sheep means in Spanish. I'm going to translate this for you, okay? I'm going to read in English and I'm going to say in Spanish what's the meaning of this. White sheep, oveja blanca, en una colina azul. Cuando el viento se detiene, ahí permaneces. Cuando el viento sopla, te vas caminando lejos. Oveja blanca, ¿a dónde vas? Remember, the clouds could be, the form of the clouds could be sometimes animals, like the sheep, okay? So, it's your turn to make a picture of the poem. You already have a picture here, but you can make a picture. Okay, for this. Please, let's go to page number 39. I want you to see the structure of the simple past to be. Okay, do you remember this? Let's check. We have the pronouns here, I, he, she, it, the third person, the singular, okay? Was not. For example, was not, is wasn't with the contraction, wasn't, okay? Let me, wasn't, okay? And were not, weren't, were not, weren't, okay? Look, I was not at home yesterday. I was at home yesterday, for example, okay? And these are the questions. I told you about to change the pronoun and the verb to make questions. Do you remember this? Okay. What are we going to do here? We are going to make some exercises in your notebook, okay? For example, look at this girl. The girl asked him, were you at school this morning? Were you at school this morning? ¿Estuviste en la escuela esta mañana? No, I wasn't. We were at the theater. No, I wasn't. We were at the theater. Okay? We are going to use this structure to complete these sentences. Okay? Use was, wasn't, were, or weren't. We're going to do this together. Okay? Yesterday morning, for example, let me change my tool here because we are going to write, okay? For example, yesterday morning, I wasn't at home, okay? Yesterday morning, I wasn't at home, okay? Okay, yesterday morning, I wasn't at home. Number two, yesterday afternoon, my friend was here. Was here. For example. Number three, two summers ago, my family and I were on vacation. Were on vacation or were to the beach. Fuimos a la playa, were to the beach. O estábamos en la playa, mejor dicho. Just wait for me. Went to the beach, okay? Number four, last Saturday, my friends, were at the movies. My friends were at the movies, okay? And number five, a year ago, I was in school. I was at school. Okay, I was at school. So much better. Okay, I was at school. To make these sentences, you need to see the structure of the simple past to be, okay? Para poder hacer esto, I want to talk to you in Spanish. Para poder hacer esto y terminar esto, o poder hacer más ejercicios, tienes que revisar la estructura del verbo to be, okay? Tienes que revisar muy bien cómo escribir, y eso te lo enseñé en el video anterior. Cómo escribir el verbo to be en tiempo pasado, ¿sí? ¿Te acuerdas que te dije? Te lo voy a escribir aquí. Fíjate muy bien. Vamos a buscar un espacio para poder escribir. Ok, te lo voy a escribir aquí. La estructura es para afirmativo. Y déjame cambiar, cambiar el color. Let me change the color of this, okay? For example, opacity, no. Thickness, no. The color of this. I'm going to use the green color, okay? The green color for this. For example, the affirmative. You're going to use the pronoun plus plus was or were. Plus the complement, okay? Complement. I'm going to, okay, for example, I'm going to use this, okay? I'm going to underline this, okay? Just give me a minute. I need you to understand what I'm saying. Okay? Lo voy a subrayar en verde para hacer la oración. Afirmativa, pronoun, I was at home yesterday, okay? This is the affirmative. Now, I'm going to write a negative, okay? I'm going to change the color of the ink, okay? Let me change this. Okay. I'm going to choose this. Okay. For example, negative. The structure is, okay, pronoun plus wasn't. Wasn't, weren't, plus complement, okay? Negative, pronoun plus wasn't or weren't plus complement. For example, and I'm going to take the red color to underline this sentence. For example, for example, we weren't or were not, okay, at home yesterday. We were not or weren't at home yesterday. This is the negative, okay, for the question. And I'm going to change my tool and I'm going to write the question. And I'm going to change the color of the ink. And I'm going to, okay, I'm going to use the blue color, okay? This one. Okay, for example, no, you can't see that. Okay, that's so much better. For example, for the question, okay, you're going to change the pronoun and the verb. For example, you're going to use was or were plus pronoun plus the complement, okay? I'm sorry, complement, okay? So much better. For question, was, were, plus pronoun, plus complement. For example, and I'm going to change to the blue color to underline this, okay? For example, were you at home yesterday? Okay? You have the structure affirmative, the negative structure, and the question structure. And you have some examples in here, okay? We're going to make some examples in your notebook. You have in the platform, you have an example of this, okay? You have an example of this at the platform, okay? Or let me show you, okay? I'm going to stop sharing this. Use these structures, to write questions and answers about the use of the simple past to be, okay? Okay, let me show you those examples, okay? For example, you have these pictures and those examples of complements, okay? For example, the affirmative sentence. at the movies. For example, she was at the movies. The negative sentence is she wasn't at the movies. And the question, was she at the movies? I need you to look those, to read those sentences, to look at the pictures and to try to understand the structures, the affirmative structure, the negative structure, and the question structure to ask questions, to answer the question, and to write in English, okay? It's so important you see the structures. I'm going to say that in Spanish. Es muy importante que veas la estructura, tanto afirmativa, negativa, y la estructura para la pregunta, para que tú aprendas a hacer preguntas, a contestar las preguntas y a escribir correctamente en inglés. Necesito que observes súper bien la estructura que te puse en tu libro, ¿sí? Para que puedas hacer ejemplos como el que te muestro ahorita en la pantalla. Esto lo puedes hacer en tu cuaderno, ¿ok? Tú puedes copiar esto en tu cuaderno, bajar el archivo que está en plataforma para que puedas comprender mejor la estructura, ¿ok? When you finish these activities, you finish the activities of the week, ¿ok? See you in the next class. Have a nice day.